CV run through. CV run through happened and I promise you I crumbled. And if you'll be my bodyguard, I can be your long lost pal. 500 people had applied and I was offered both. Yeah. Hi guys. Future me, present me here. I just wanted to come and say hello, hi, welcome, how are you? Thank you for tuning in today. Decided to film my application season series. You'll hear all about it anyway when you watch the video, but I'm here, future me, to fill in some gaps. I'm also here to remind you to subscribe and give the video a massive thumbs up. And most of all, I hope you enjoy the video. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Karu Culture. Excuse how I look right now. I just finished work, so basically I kind of just thought very randomly, why don't I record my application season? Right now I am about to do some research, so there's a few divisions that I feel like I'll apply for. One, operations. Two, asset management. Three, I don't know what the third is, but that's why I'm happy I'm starting now, so I can kind of figure that out. I'm really interested in consulting, but am I really interested in consulting? Don't know. Anywho, yeah, so I have a book here. I need to get like one that is designated to this. Right now, I'm just gonna go through a few articles that I find interesting, make some notes. What do I know? What don't I know? What do I understand? What don't I understand? Because I'm not gonna lie, I'm not gonna be funny. I'm sure a lot of you can relate. Being an economics student doesn't mean you know everything. It doesn't. Well, for me anyway. I done business economics at university and I still don't have a clue. I know it's really bad, but I mean, it is what it is. Applications aren't easy. I went to a non-target uni. I didn't have the best A levels, so I'm going to hammer it in now. I used to scream wealth and asset management in a university, so that's what I'm going to try and go for. I actually took Afzal Hussein's asset management course on Skillshare, which was amazing. 10 out of 10, would recommend. I've realized from doing like my research and looking at articles and stuff is that I'm finding that there's actually so much out there. There is so much out there and I'm trying to figure out how do I pick, like what is good enough for me to look at. So I'm gonna take my mate's advice, Io, when he was doing commercial awareness, he was looking at what he was interested in. So that's what I'm gonna do too. And I genuinely find this interesting, which is super weird, because a few months ago, if you asked me what you're gonna do with your life, I would have told you tech. So, always changing my mind, but you know, just gonna go for it. So right now I am, let me show you what I'm actually doing. I'm on this website called Funds Europe, and it is just one of the websites that was recommended when I took my asset management course. Yeah, so I'm kind of lost right now, but I'm gonna figure it out somehow, some way. So guys, oh my goodness, I'm so sorry for my appearance, but it's almost midnight, so please. Yeah, so I guess I'm kind of just thinking, I need to make sure this is what I want to do. I mean, I've paid for the FT now, so I'm kind of in it to win it, I guess. I don't know, whenever I add a direct debit to my account and I think about it. Anywho, I'm just waffling because I'm tired. But any investment into you, yourself, is the best investment you can do. Like, I've invested into myself so much. So I'm just so excited to see where it all goes, where however much it pays off. And yeah, just keep it going, keep it pushing. I actually created a Google Doc. Let me see if I can show you. So this is the little dictionary I'm putting together for my when I read like commercial awareness stuff, just so I understand, because sometimes it's just a bit too much. Morning. I thought I'll just come and talk to you guys quickly about where I'm at with my journey for application season. So I've set myself the task of reading articles, 2 articles every day from the FT or Investment Week or somewhere. But I'm actually struggling with like remembering to do that just because I work. I have YouTube. So when it comes to reading articles, another reason why I kind of have this struggle and this battle is because I actually forget to finish reading the article. I will literally go on the FT, guns blazing, reading the article, maybe second paragraph in, come across a term that I don't understand. I remember this literally happened yesterday. I came across the term exchange traded funds. I think that's what it is, ETFs anyway. And I went on Investopedia and I just went in finding out about everything I can when it comes to exchange traded funds. Trading funds? Traded funds. Can't even remember now. And then I forgot to go back to finish the article because I spent so long reading about ETFs. And where it is good, I kind of want to make sure that I am finishing the articles. So yeah, it's really interesting. I abandoned the idea of going into finance and banking, and I don't know why. Maybe I gave up a bit, or I just thought, do you know what, maybe that's just not for me. But I have this feeling, I don't know how to describe it, but I have this feeling like this is what I'm supposed to be doing. This is what I've always been interested in doing. So before I rule it out, at least try. I really do hope I secure something this year because it'll be amazing. No doubt that if I try my hardest, I will anyway. I just have that much faith in myself. So I actually managed to bag myself an interview at one of the world's largest asset managers in client services. I have been banging on about client services, asset wealth management, since I was a mere slip of a girl, young in my adolescence at university. And I was so happy I had secured this interview. But I was also, the pressure was on. Like, I felt so much pressure. I was kind of just like, oh my gosh, I'm freaking out. I know I come on here to like do videos on this, but it's just like, damn. Oh, I have to perform. Like, I literally have to perform. This is something I've wanted for a very, very long time. Right now, I am working on my interview preps. I need to know any and everything that could come up in this interview, and if I don't, then I'm going to have at least some sort of knowledge, and or I'm just gonna have to be completely honest and be like, I don't know at this time, but I can get back to you on that. Yeah, but anywho, from what products the firm offers to competency questions, behavioral questions, technical questions, I have to genuinely be interested in what I'm saying to be able to talk about it in an interview and bring off my enthusiasm and excitement. So I really like to go in on the firm's values. I create a table, and in that table it's listed with the firm's values, how they show their values, and how I show their values. It just gives a nice, well-rounded approach to my answers, especially when I talk about how they have shown their values, because that also shows that you have done company research and you're not just talking about how much money they've made, etc., etc. I like to do things kind of off the dome, so I'm not too rehearsed in interviews, so I'll just put like little bullet points down. Apart from commercial awareness that I struggle to remember, I will really, some may say rehearse a bit, rehearse in a natural way. But yeah, for the most part, I am just pretty relaxed in my approach. I'm really excited because I feel like I'm a lot more confident than I was before, for sure. I just need to make sure that I know my stuff. I always say, make sure you know your stuff. I need to make sure I know my stuff.
I forgot. I always write down everything I need to do in this notepad. And for my interview prep, I have different types of preparation. Not just I'm going to do my profile. So for example, add my interviewers on LinkedIn. That is a part of my preparation. I feel like it shows that you're confident and you want them to see you and know you and see what you get up to. I'm quite active on LinkedIn. That's why I feel like it really helps them to get a sense of my personality. I also add members of staff that do work at the company, especially in a division that I've applied to, so I can have a chat with them and find out, like, how do you find the job? Are you working on anything interesting that you can tell me about? Why do you work for the firm that you work for. My interviewers have connected with me on LinkedIn, so they have probably seen my profile. Yeah, I don't know, I'm really excited. I can just say I'm really excited. It's the experience that matters to me mostly of all. I am so honoured to even have gotten one, so.
So what is client services? For my role that I had applied for in particular, it was to do with managing the day-to-day relationships with the firm's intermediary investors. So for example, financial advisors and also institutional investors, which are pension funds. And I really wanted to go for this kind of opportunity just because I feel like client services is one of the areas of the business where you can learn and soak up as much information as you possibly can, like a sponge. I'm a learner. I love absorbing information. I love knowing things. So to position myself accordingly to perhaps figure out what kind of area or my interests were in within asset management, I would position myself in client services. In client services, no 2 days are the same, no 2 interactions are the same, no 2 clients are the same. You're going to get asked questions, maybe some are similar, maybe they're not, but it's just that excitement, like, oh, what's gonna happen now? What am I gonna have to go and learn? What am I gonna have to go find out? That made client services very exciting for me. Hopefully have the opportunity to just dive right in, get stuck in, and
hi guys, so I have my interview tomorrow with one of the largest asset managers in the world. I have literally 11 pages worth of content for this interview. Yes, I love to over prepare. So yeah, I'm just gonna go through a few questions. Why are you passionate about investments in the financial markets? I'm passionate about investments because I believe investments gives great insight into the behaviour of humans. This sparks my passion for investments because it gives you more insight into human behaviour than any other field. It's personal, emotional, political and cultural. See, and now I freeze. So I think what comes next. That's why I don't, oh, by the way, that's why I don't really like reading straight off the screen. A bit more natural, a bit more conversational, a bit more moi. Why are you passionate about investments in the financial markets? I'm passionate about investments because I believe it's the best way to get to know. No. I'm passionate about investments because it get all out now, so tomorrow I'm saying it clean, okay? When it comes to questions like when, tell me about a time, star method that, and also you want to tell, it's like you're telling a story with a beginning, middle and end. You want to, you know, just make it marinate, you want to marinate it, like you want to make them interested and engaged, not just jump right in. So yeah, it's kind of weird for me right now because like these are just my notes and my notes are like the points that I need to make sure I get across, but I can't forget to tell the whole story.
I never actually explained what happened in the interview, so let me give you the lowdown. I was actually put up for 2 roles and I did not know. I only found out on the second interview that I had. So I had an interview on a Thursday, I believe, and I had an interview on a Friday. So on the Thursday interview, it was with not so senior employees at the firm. And I thought, cool. But then I had also got an email saying I have an interview for the Friday. And on the Friday, I had an interview with the manager. So I don't know why. I just kind of thought I was fast-tracked to being interviewed by both. And then they'll just, you know, give me the job. So I was like proper hyped, proper gassed. Like, I was stoked. And then I had my interview on the Thursday. Then I get to my interview on Friday and basically they tell me like this is for a whole new role that I'm interviewing for. Like, how crazy is that? So in the interview I'm starting to sweat now. I'm thinking, okay, because basically my mindset was that was the first round, I'm now onto the second round. So I'm not going to get asked questions that I was asked the day before on the Thursday, and now it's just me getting to know the manager and them asking me a whole bunch of different questions. But that was not the case. There's like a whole another interview, like boom, CV run through happened, and I promise you I crumbled. Like, when I say I crumbled, like, because I was so shook up from the fact that I had like potentially two offers going. Yeah, so then I actually just said, let me just take a breather. Sorry. And then I started again, and from there we went flying. It was so good. I promise you, I left that interview thinking, I am that girl. I was actually told from that interview that I'll probably have two offers on the table. What? Like, what? Me? So, I was so happy knowing that. And how it worked, for one role, I had three interviews. The other role, I had two interviews. Oh, there was one interview round, the last one for the three interviews, where I got asked a question like, oh, so give me a 30 second elevator pitch on what you would tell someone about the firm. I promise you, nah. When I tell my friends, yeah, if I ever get asked a question that spins my brain, I'll just smile. And that's what I did. That's what I did. I just smiled. Then I had to play it off. I had to play it cool. I was just like, oh, okay, did you want me to start now? Sorry, I didn't know. And they were just like, yeah, go. That's when I done the 30-second elevator pitch. And in my head, I was thinking, do I go with more of the hardcore facts, or do I go more with the what I care about when it came to the company that I had applied to? So I definitely went with what I cared about, because it's so much easier for me to speak about. So I done that, and yeah, that's probably the only question I've ever been asked where like it made me feel hot. Like, I just did not know what was going on. Yeah, so that's kind of how, that's how the interview stages
so
went.
I had my first round interview, which was really, it felt really good.
Yes, I have my next one like literally in an hour and 10 minutes. So I'm just in the press. I'm just gonna show you like my pre-interview prep.
I feel so nervous right now. I think you can tell I'm nervous.
We're not nervous. That doesn't mean, what is that? That is not in our vocabulary. We're gonna boss this. We're excited for this opportunity. So next interview is in about an hour. I think for me, I'm going off on a tangent here. For me, I put all of this work in, and when things start to materialize, it's kind of just like, damn, is this really happening? I think that's imposter syndrome, right? Which I don't want to put on myself. I know I work very hard for what I want to achieve, but sometimes it's just like crazy. It's wild. Yeah, so I've done all the interview prep that I can. Any questions that come my way, I will answer to the best of my ability. The only thing I can do is my best. So I love to wear an outfit that will make me feel empowered. Like, I am that boss. You're going in there, you're going to secure the job. So whatever I wear, I always make sure that I am dressed to impress, but most of all, just to impress myself. For example, if I was to wear a shirt and shorts on the bottom, I wouldn't feel as juiced up, shall I say. Basically, let me just explain to you my pre-interview ritual. How it goes is, get everything set up, make sure everything's working, which I need to do soon. Clear background, so I actually do my interviews in here on this wall. You can see my shirt nicely steamed and ready to wear. And I do like this dance session. I have a pre-interview like mini playlist. It's like two or three songs, and I just shake off all the nerves. I am just so like free in that moment, in that time, and really speak words of positivity to myself. Like, when I'm dancing, I'm just like, yeah, you got this. Next, sit myself down and look in the mirror and speak words of affirmation. You've got this. You're that girl. You deserve anything you go after because you work hard for it. After I do affirmation, I pray. Honestly, I don't know where I'd be if it wasn't for God, so I pray. And then we do this. Then we do this. 20 minutes to my interview. Listen, I always have to wear like a perfume before I start, just to give me the vibes, like the confidence. Ooh! The C is really good, it's not too strong, it's not going to distract me whilst I'm speaking. It's the perfect womanly scent to harness the female lioness that I am.
Okay, I'm doing too much, but you get the point. And now it's dance time. Let's get them AirPods. And I literally just dance. Please forgive me because I may look crazy, but this is what we do. Hints and allegations. If you'll be my bodyguard, I can be your long lost pal. I can call you Betty, and Betty, when you call me, you can call me out. Call me out. The result. I mean, you would have already seen probably from my title, I got both offers. Yes, I'm so blessed, so grateful, so humbled to have been offered both offers, especially because they were only taking one. Oh, I didn't even explain this. So basically, both roles were for client services, but different aspects of client services. So different different types of clients. One was for personal investors, so everyday people like me and you. And as I've said already, the other one was for institutional and intermediary investors. So that's where they used to divide. So yeah, your girl got both offers and I had to pick. I mean, I have never been in this position before. I've told you guys, like, I've never secured a spring week, a summer internship, any sort of experience in the real world until I had left university. So it was kind of like, yeah, it's still not even sunk in, really, I don't think. This was such a massive achievement for me because each offer was only for one in that whole division. And to know that over 500 people had applied for those roles and I was offered both, yeah. And I think it just goes to show that whatever you want to do, as no matter how long it takes, you can get there. You know me, I always have to come with a lame corny quote. I start soon and I've actually been to dinner with my new team, and let me just say I am so happy. They are so wonderful, so lovely, so welcoming, and yeah, I'm excited to take you guys on this new chapter of my life. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please remember to hit that subscribe button, give your girl a massive thumbs up, and always comment. Let's interact in the comments, let's chat. I'm always here happy, as you can probably tell. If you watched a few of my videos, I talk a lot. So yeah, always feel free to reach out to me as well. Have a lovely week. Bye.